One of our viewers recently asked, what happens with these old controllers when the wires are so badly deteriorated that they don't work anymore? And asked if we could show how to replace them. So I found an old controller in my boneyard with deteriorated wires, and I found that I did have a piece of new wire that was suitable. This is 4-conductor wire. The switches have 3 conductors on each side, but the length is right, and we're just going to omit one of the conductors. And the other thing you need to know when you're looking at any of this is what kind of tools should you use. I'm going to need a wire stripper, wire cutters, needle nose pliers, a small screwdriver. This is a little vise that I have just to hold everything in place if I need to be. And on the far side of the table over here, since I'm old and don't see as well as I used to, I have a head magnifier, and finally way over here, solder and soldering iron. So with that, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video and begin to take this controller apart. On the bottom of the controller, you will find 2 screws, and without getting in the way too much, I'm going to take these 2 screws out of this one, and we'll see what lies underneath. There are some mechanical parts, which you'll see. So you push on the levers from the top, and out comes the mechanism. I'm going to set the cover aside. It's phenolic, so it can be washed. And inside, you'll see a mechanism with some levers and a light bulb. And if I move it aside, this is the controller mechanism, which hopefully you can get a good look at now. So what I want to do is, the wires are going to have to be soldered to these brass posts. And rather than try to get them down inside where they originally were soldered, I am going to tack solder my wires to the outside of the posts. So the first thing we need to do is to get rid of the old wires, which are really, really a mess. So I'm going to start by snipping back here, snipping these guys out, and noting where they go. And what you're going to find is the middle wire of the 3 is the one that you need to pay the most attention to. So that turns out to be an outside wire. That was an outside wire. And here's another one. And another one. So it turns out that the middle wire of both of these cables went to the point where you see the light bulb. And I'm going to snip these away so we can get a look at what's going on in here. So with that, I'm going to clean this up. I'm going to clean up my work platform, and I'm going to begin the process. I'm first going to dig all the old insulation out, make sure the areas where I'm going to solder to are clean and ready to accept the wiring. And then I'm going to begin one by one to solder the new wires in place. So again, I'm going to pause the video. I'm going to continue on with prepping the wire, and I've done a little bit of this here. This is 4-conductor wire, and to make it 3, I've just peeled away the end conductor of the wire. And at the other end of the wire, I've just left it with the insulation not removed. So here you can see these are the three conductors that we're actually going to use. And how I did this, here's the other half of the wire that I had found. And again, this is stuff that's just been around. You can buy this though. And you should buy wire that is no lighter than 24 AWG or American wire gauge. 22 or 24 are recommended. So here are my four conductors. So what I'm going to do is just basically travel along the length of wire until I find the conductor I don't want, which is the one on this end. And I'm going to take my cutting pliers and just nip it a little bit. All these wires are probably what you'd call a zip wire. So I'm just going to pull this away because I don't want it. And that way I'll have the three conductors of interest. So to prepare my wire, I just start by nipping them a little bit and pulling them apart. And then I take my wire strippers. Oh, and what I didn't do is keep track of who I don't want, and that's this guy. And the other thing I recommend doing with the wire before you start to solder it to the switch is to tin it. And if you're not real familiar with soldering practices, you should probably practice a little bit before you do this, although it's nothing critical. But in tinning it, you basically just heat your wire and apply some solder. And this will help solderability when you're ready to finish your job. So I'm going to do the same thing with the other wire. I'm going to prep it and pause the video, and then we'll actually insert it into the switch controller. Now what's really important with the wiring is the middle wires, because those middle wires end up going to the outside rails of the track, which Lionel calls neutral or common. So both of these middle wires of my three conductor cable have to go to this point right here, if you can see them clearly on the video. So what I'm going to do is to take one of the middle wires and then the other one, and then using my needle nose pliers, and I'm probably going to block the view, but I'm going to bring them up and over the top of that post, and I'm going to turn up the heat on my soldering iron so it's kind of maxed out. And what I'm going to do is to heat that middle post with those wires. And although it's steel, it should solder. Don't touch it when you're done because it's going to be like white hot. Okay. So now I have the middle post, the center post, with the middle wire soldered to it. So with that, we're going to spread out our two bundles of wire, one to each side of the switch. And where do they go? Well, one of them is going to travel up alongside the light bulb. And what I've done with the wire is I've just kind of wrapped it around the brass post that's up there. And heated it. And that guy has landed at that point. And the other one, if you remember when you took it apart, landed at the front. And it's not quite as easy. And I know I'm blocking the view of the camera, but I'll show it to you when I have it where I want it. I pushed it under this point right here. So I'm going to, while I have it captured, solder it under there. And we're going to see what happens. Hopefully the solder got to the wire. Let it cool for a moment. Give it a tug, and it's there. So this is one of the two sides of this, and rather than bore you with soldering the other side, I'll point out that I've soldered the wires to here and to here. These are the switch contact points that will activate either the red or the green. The center, as I mentioned earlier, ends up going to the outside of the track rails or the circuit common. What I'm going to do is solder up the other side, and then we'll give it a test run. So in this last snapshot, well, not quite complete, but I have a switch, and over in the distance is a controller. It could be a transformer. In my case, it's just a model train controller that I've designed. But here's my switch control, and I have my switch connected to one side. And you can see that as I turn the levers, the little shade goes over the lamp so that I'll have, when I put it together, my red and my green indication. Now the other side does the same thing, except right now my wires are unconnected. I only have one switch. And on this side, this is the side that happens to activate the light bulb, so what I have connected. And you can see it all seems to work quite well with the wire I have in there. I'm going to put the cover over it for one last look. So here it is together, and it's very difficult to see the red and green indicators on the top because the bulb doesn't really light up that bright. But in the dark, yes, they can be seen. And in this case, I happen to be lucky, and the red on the switch agrees with the red on the controller. In the event it doesn't, all you have to do is turn the two wires on the end and everything matches up. What wire should you buy? Well, this is black. It matches what Lionel originally had. But you can buy three conductor wire from many, many sources. You can get it with a gray jacket. Wire for wiring telephones, although it's a little on the thin side, actually does work with these. So you can get it from anywhere from, say, 30 cents a foot up to $1 a foot, the real Lionel three conductor. I found on the internet and it was about $1 a foot. So that's what your wire will cost you. The switches came with about 3 feet, 2.5 feet of wire from Lionel. So this pretty much replicates what they were. And you can see the controller, I cleaned it up a little bit with soapy water. It looks fine. This is a nicer switch. This is from the late 40s. But all Lionel switches are pretty much the same. The center connection on the switch, and I'll use the pointer, I guess it'll be helpful. The center connection on the switch ends up going to the outside rails of the track, even if they're non-derailing. And then the light bulb in here is actually activated by the solenoid inside one of the two switches that goes to that particular connection. So hopefully you found the video informative, and if you go to repair your switch controller, you'll be able to work your way through it. Thanks for watching. As always, have a great and safe day.